So again, sometimes doing these textures can be a type of trial and error type of situation here. So now if I try this one, I'm going to hit Ctrl Shift U on the image just so that I use it as a grayscale image. So if we save it and check what it looks like. I'm not really liking this one as much as I liked the other one. So I'm going to dispose of that one. And I can probably scale this one. Again, as I said, this is a trial and error type of thing. You have to keep checking back at the model. Also, you have to watch out for the seam that you create when you're texturing this. And again, as I said, that's the problem of having something that has light. That can really affect the way the texture comes out to be. And maybe we can try and fix that here within the original texture. I think this looks a lot better than before. And again, things like the panels, we can just try to, maybe we can just try to hand paint the panels. So let me show you what I mean. I'm going to create a new layer, use my marquee select, I'm going to drag a really tiny, tiny line along the already existing panel from the image. Okay, I'm going to hit all backspace with black. As you can see, I kind of created the panel there. And duplicate that. I can just merge all those. I can also create the panel going the other way. I should save it and go check. And I can set this to something like soft light and decrease the opacity. Save it and see what it looks like. Okay, so it's starting to come along. Of course, it needs more work. But you get the idea of how I'm going about making this. So after we do that, we can start to overlay more textures. And we can also get some decals that we can use. This is so that, you know, it looks more unique and it doesn't look the same. It doesn't look like it has had some type of repeating texture all over it. And also, as you may notice, I'm already like trying to get all the details for this part, but the best thing to do usually is to gradually create all the base textures for everything and gradually start to increase with the details and all that type of thing. So the way I'm doing it here is not as practical. Okay, so make sure you gradually increase detail and all that for everything as a whole instead of paying too much attention to one specific piece like I'm doing here. And again, I'm making mine, I want mine to look pretty old, pretty rusty. And also I'm looking at it from this angle because, as I said, this is for a type of third person type of game. So I want it to be, I want to be looking at it from kind of far away. Okay, so the next time we're just going to continue to texture. In the meantime, I recommend that you, I pretty much already showed you how, basically this is my process of texturing something like this. So pretty much we're just going to see more of the same.